G'day everyone, I'm Sean, and welcome to Blade Mate Lawn Care. Apologies for the lack of content in recent weeks. There's a few things going on behind the scenes in my life at the moment which have taken priority. That said, it felt great to get back out on the tools and make this video for you. Now this job has a pretty cool story. A few months back, I was invited to an afternoon tea at my local State Member for Parliament's office, where I met a few lovely people involved in my community. A local lady contacted that office recently because she had been struggling to get support from the aged care system, who provide some funding for household assistance such as yard work, cleaning, and those sort of things. Now, one of the lovely team members I met there reached out to me and put me in touch with this client. I dropped by and we had a chat about what work she needed, her budget, etc. She had a few contractors provide quotes for the standard edge, mow and blow, which is the basic service a lawn mowing business offers. The prices she mentioned were in line with what I would have also quoted, however it was still a little bit out of her price range. So for the first visit, just to get the place tidy up, I was able to offer that free of charge, and then we locked in a price which suited her budget moving forward. Despite this, she still insisted on offering some money for this first service, which we put to good use with a ute load of garden mulch, but you'll see that shortly. I hope you enjoy this video. Have a great day.
God, man, it won't get finished sitting down like that.
Well, so are you waiting, Sue?
My back's hurting just watching what you're gonna do.
I just called in some backup, but in the meantime, this lovely client is definitely looking after me on this job. Just gonna take five with some tea and cake. Here's a reinforcement. Once again, Tyler from Hunter Valley Grass. Check out his channel, Mowing for Mental Health. I'll leave a link for that one in the description. Thanks for coming, mate.
No worries.
Great for like taking with you on a motorbike. Put it in your saddlebag.
Handy little bit of kit, mate. That's why the design hasn't changed since like pre-World War I.
Yeah.
Like diggers got more kills with this thing than they did with their bayonets and bullets, man. This is the best thing they had though. Ammo was short, so they'd just carry this into when they charge into a trench and start aiming at their heads.
Thank you.
Yeah.